Papa Squat, coming at you once again from my secret headquarters here in my volcano lair. So we're moving into 1980 here, and we're moving to someone I like a lot, Kurtis Blow. He's got a number of songs that I'm sure we'll get to that I really like. I think he's a good rapper. This was his first hit called The Breaks. And this is a video. It's him on Soul Train performing. A couple of interesting things about this is this is, I think, the youngest rapper we've seen so far. He's like 21 or 22 here. So this is a kid who kind of struck gold right off the bat, did a great job, maintained a career certainly throughout the 80s, had a good beat. Also had mastered the ability to keep his song to a reasonable amount of time. So this is a 3-minute and 42-second song, and let's just give it a listen. There's a little bit of an intro here where there's no noise and it's just Kurtis Blow looking all sexy. Everybody, if you got what it takes, cause I'm Kurtis Blow and I want you to know that these are the words. So you can already tell he knows what he's doing. He's got a good voice. He's definitely got some swagger. He's got a hook to the song, like immediately. We're in the first 32 seconds and he's already done these are the breaks. Break it up, break it up, break it up. He knows what he's doing. You'll also notice there is not very much of a disco influence here. I heard a little bit of a kind of a Spanish drum in the background, or the Spanish beat. Which is fine. I mean, it's fine. It sounded good, but very not disco-y to me. So two things. Ma Bell is what they used to call, what was it, AT&T? Bell Telephone, which was eventually in the 80s declared a monopoly, and they had to break up into all sorts of different telephone companies. Now it's not really like that because everybody's got cell phones, and instead we have regional monopolies, which are apparently not monopolies. So I guess I'm talking about cable TV, not cell phones, because you can go to cell phone companies and they cover everywhere. And then the other thing that we're back to with this song by Kurtis Blow is talking about how much life sucks. Borrowed money from the mob, Ma Bell is sending you a big phone call with 15 phone calls to Brazil, your girlfriend ran away with some guy to Japan, the IRS wants to talk to you. It seems to be a consistent theme throughout a lot of rap songs, is like how sucky things are. Well, these are the breaks. Break it up, break it up, break it up. So those drums are what Sheila E. plays, and if you have not heard Sheila E. play drums, she is absolutely incredible on her drums. She plays Occupation, genre, instruments, vocals, percussion, drums. Come on, she has like a specific type of drum that she plays that she's absolutely incredible with. So if you go and look at her song, The Glamorous Life, I can't find the instrument she plays, but it's absolutely, she's absolutely incredible. Anyway, I'll keep looking. So pretty good. I'm a big fan. It's a good song. It's short. It tells you everything you want to know very, very quickly. Well, very quickly. I mean, it's a nice compact song with a good hook, some good lines throughout to keep you entertained. The music is great. And I want to show you Sheila E. playing. Apparently, these are just Congo drums. We're gonna see if this will show up all right here. So, Sheila E. concert in Oakland, California. Let's see if we've got a, we're gonna advance, oh, here we go. She's incredible. So these are the drums in the background of that song. So she's using a lot of the cowbell there, but when you can get a clear earshot of when she's playing the conga drums themselves, you'll see or you'll hear how similar or exactly alike they are to the drum beats that were in the background of Kurtis Blow's song. I just want her to get to the drums. Let me see if I can advance here. No. She's doing the whole song. All I want is the drum solo. Oh yeah, here we go. Jeez, I'm a huge drum fan. I actually saw this will give you an idea how old I am. I saw the Prince Purple Rain tour. I don't know if I was 13 or something like that, but loved Prince. And Sheila E. was his opening act, and she absolutely blew me away with the conga drum, as you just saw there. Incredible. I encourage you to check out more stuff by her. She's been playing the conga drum since she was 3 years old, I think I read, and definitely worth listening to. Anyway, this was about Kurtis Blow. This was a very good song. There is no surprise why it was a hit song and why Kurtis Blow continued to have a good career, because he continued to make songs that resonated with people and that were very, very cool. I hope you liked it, because I certainly did. Papa Squat! Have a good day.